morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are. I'm Paul Clark, and welcome to my studio. So, what have I got for you lovely lot today? Well, we're going to have a go at something a little bit simpler this week. We're going to have a look at this lovely little river scene with a fisherman. But just before we start, a quick announcement. There won't be a video tutorial for the next 2, maybe 3 weeks, as we're off to Ibiza tomorrow for our watercolour workshop there. And when we get back, we'll be going straight to our event here in Sussex. But there'll still be plenty to do, lots of old videos to watch. And of course, Margot will continue to do her weekly challenges on Facebook. So come and join us, and we'll paint this step by step together. So here is the stunning photo reference, and I'd like to say a big thank you to Chris Benson for sending me this. Now, he tells me it's a photo of his son fishing after a thunderstorm on the west branch of the Delaware River. Okay, so for today's materials, my paper is some Arche cold press. It's 100% cotton and on a block, so it won't need stretching. But of course, any decent watercolour paper will do. My colours today are yellow ochre, cobalt blue, Payne's grey, and just a smidge of burnt sienna. And my brushes today, I've got a large Harke, then from my range, a 3/4 inch flat, number 12 and number 6 round. And here's the pencil sketch, which as always is free to download from my website, link in the description below. Off we go, and I'm using my large Harke brush and completely saturating the whole sheet of paper. And it's important to let all the water completely soak into the paper. We don't want any surface water. Then using my flat brush, I'm just putting in some yellow ochre straight into the wet paper. And then next with a little touch of cobalt blue, and I'm always trying to line up my reflections. Next, some Payne's grey, and I'm trying to keep that section behind the figure paint free to keep that sense of light bursting through and reflecting on the water. And I'm beginning to really build up the darker values in the corners. Next, for these misty trees, and I'm using a much stronger consistency of paint and dropping in these fairly simple blobby shapes into the wet. And as I move towards the left, the paint begins to run out on my brush, creating a lighter wash, suggesting the trees are further in the distance. And here I'm using a clean, damp brush to lift off some of the paint to create the water's edge, all very soft and misty. And then back to these nearer trees to create some very subtle details. And the exact same approach on this side. And you'll notice that I'm holding my number 12 brush fairly far down the handle. It just helps me to get those more natural looking flicky strokes. And here, still into the wet wash, some quick horizontal strokes to suggest some movement in the water. So I'm letting it dry and I realize it's not how I hoped it would turn out. Far too light and far too much light on the water. So a decision has to be made. Do I start again or try and salvage this painting? After all, it is a good sheet of ash. So making sure it's totally dry, I'm re-wetting the sheet again with clean water. And you'll see that it's actually softening everything, which is not a bad thing. Now this is still clean water, but it's really pulling up the dry paint and spreading it across the sheet, which is much easier to do with non-staining colours like Payne's Grey. And it's going to give the whole sheet a slightly darker value under wash, which is not a bad thing. So I'm going to get more colour in this time and starting with some cobalt blue and then again with some Payne's Grey. Now this is definitely one of the advantages of using good quality cotton paper like this sheet of ash. Not only does it stay wetter longer, it will take a lot of punishment, so re-wetting several times is really not an issue. Now, I often get viewers ask me about the snazzy green tape I use. Well, it's not really. It's just cheap, low-tech builder's masking tape from the local DIY. So this time I'm really making sure I get more darker values onto the paper, but still leaving that little shaft of light. And I'm still using my flat brush. So next, cleaning and drying my brush and lifting out some soft edge highlights. And as the main wash begins to dry, I'm painting in a few more subtle ripples. So I'm doing exactly the same as I did before and painting in these trees with a very strong creamy mix of Payne's Grey. Definitely got a bit of deja vu here. And using the flat brush on its side, you can get some really effective tree shapes. So this tree over here is more of a deciduous type, so I'm trying to create the impression of a canopy of leaves. But it's all still very much a wet in wet process. So now we need to let this totally dry, so it's a perfect time for a short break. And what about a glass of Fortescue's Fisherman's Ale? It does exist. Next for the rocks, and I'm coming in with a strong consistency of Payne's Grey. And here, dragging my brush flat to the surface to pick up that dry brush effect from the texture of the paper. Now, the thing about these rocks is I don't want to make them look too obvious with too many crisp and sharp edges, so I'm softening the top of some of the rocks with clean water. I also like to smooth and smudge some of the edges with my finger. Now, for these rocks further back, I'm lightening the value and also softening some of the edges.
You can turn the tide, let the water go where it wants to go. You can run and hide, you can bury yourself beneath the stones. Somebody told me don't pretend, 'cause everyone could use a friend sometimes. Take some good advice. A breath. Let me be a part of something real. Someone said it's better when you hold on to a helping hand. Sometimes we could all use a friend.
Now for the fisherman, and I'm using my smaller number 6 brush and using just a small amount of burnt sienna, and this is really the only touch of warm colour in the whole painting. And while it's still wet, I'm painting in the rest with some Payne's Grey. Now the thing to remember is the figure is almost in silhouette against the light, so you really don't want to include any detail. But take your time and carefully fill in the shape, especially around his face. Somebody's waiting down the line to pick up the pieces. Hey, they'll be alright. There will be someone waiting down the line. Okay, so now for the reflection, and I'm going to be using 3 techniques for this, starting with wet on dry using my number 6 brush. Then I'm going to do some wet in wet by dropping in clean water into the wet paint, but also dropping in wet paint into the wet wash. Then the dry brush technique to pick up the texture of the paper. Now, what I love about a pointed round brush like this number 6 is you get those lovely tapered ends to your brush strokes, which is perfect for water ripples. And for those of you who are interested, the West Branch of the Delaware River is 90 miles long and flows through the US states of New York and Pennsylvania, including the Catskill Mountains. Now, about halfway along, it has the Cannonsville Dam and Reservoir, which supplies New York City with its drinking water. Now, apparently, because I know nothing about fishing, its waters provide one of the best fly fishing trout streams in the whole of the US. See here, I'm using very dry paint here, almost direct from the tube. And of course, these ripples, as we move to the distance, they need to get smaller and slightly lighter. And here I'm just putting in a very light watery wash just to suggest some movement in the water. A few minor details in the foreground trees. And of course, we need to finish off with the tricky bit and paint in his rod. Just make sure it tapers out at the end. There we go, all done, and this one in about 2 hours. Well, I hope you enjoyed that as much as I did, and you'll give it a go. Just remember, make it your own, splash around with the paint, have fun, all the usuals. And of course, please don't forget to like, subscribe if you haven't already, it is free, leave a comment. I do read every single one, can't always reply to them all. And I look forward to seeing you all again in 2, maybe 3 weeks. Have a great time, everyone.